Dan Riehl is the owner of realworldview.com. It's a blog. Well, you're not really the owner. What do they call you? The publisher? The editor at large? What is your name, Dan? What is your title?
The idiot who publishes the post. I think they call me a blogger.
A blogger, that's it. Let me try to do this since our time is limited today. A few weeks ago, Jesse Griffin, the publisher, the blogger from Immoral Minority, did a post which said that the Palins were Splitsville. Now, I want to just preface all this. We're not saying Jesse Griffin's done anything illegal. You can decide for yourself whether it's appropriate or not or inappropriate. I want to make that very well clear. What my point is in this is to understand where these bloggers, who they're connected with, where they come from, their past, and therefore, when people get these stories out, they understand, okay, consider the source. There you go. Consider the source. That's it. Dan? We're not trying to allege people have done things illegally or anything, but when you find out the background about people, you can say, okay, well, I can, he also said that Trigg was not Sarah Palin's child, that it did not, quote, come from her uterus. Just really despicable things that the man has said, called about these shoes that she wore, his F me pumps, talking about how he teaches boys to swish when they walk, and how because
what I think, Eddie, is that maybe it's too much court TV and people get confused between journalism and what a district attorney does, and that's not my job, and all I can do. And I never allege that anyone has done anything wrong. You know, you look at facts, and those facts may lead you to other facts. And all along the way, you do your best to confirm the facts by being, rigorous and being honest. And as you find one fact, and it leads you to another, and you examine around that fact, and you either throw it out or keep it, and you go in a path, and then you lay that path out. It doesn't mean anything more than that.
But, Dan, we have come to a place where, let's say you're 40-something years old, you've grown up, and you think, okay, well, if it's reported out there in the news and all, then, there's probably truth to it. But today it's changed with the blogosphere and all, and it's changed because there's different media outlets who now we understand have agendas. And so it's so important that just because you hear it anymore, I don't know, you have to go to other sources to double check things. And I just wanted to spend a short time here today. Tell us, I guess I'm going to try to summarize. I know it's tough to do it in 10 minutes, but we have found that Jesse Griffin was a kindergarten school teacher's assistant, and he resigned after his blog was found out. About in the content of his blog, I guess that's why he resigned. He must have felt it was inappropriate or whatever. I don't know exactly the reasons. He won't come on the show. We've invited the man on the show. But now we've wondered, well, wait a minute. If he's a kindergarten teacher's assistant, he has a $300,000 house. How does he make the payment? I mean, and I have questions into the school district. Did you know of this gentleman's content in his blog? If you were aware, why did you hire him? If you weren't aware,
the school district definitely owes someone an explanation, because they're charged with hiring people, screening people, and knowing what they're about. And if someone determines what this guy was about, and I'm not making that determination, I don't live in Alaska. If someone who's going to send their child to a certain place gets the impression after reading, this whole story that might not be where they want their child to be, that doesn't mean it's true, but I think the school board, to be accountable to the people, at least should explain why or why not, given that many people who read this story will feel maybe this wasn't appropriate, but that's not my determination to make.
And they can read the whole story at Riehl, realworldview.com, realworldview.com. Okay, try in your best way to summarize here what we've kind of gone over earlier today.
Okay, well, all I did was put out a lot of facts, and I have sources, and they're reliable, and I don't put out things that I don't have a definite site for. And what I was told is that, you know, listed as Eddie's current employer was
or
the
Jesse's.
Puffin Hills.
Jesse's
the
current
school,
employer.
As Jesse's. Was this Puffin Hills Montessori School, which is actually a preschool. Now, so what do you do when you get that information? I didn't make that up. I have a reliable source for that. I called there, and they said, not here, hasn't been here in 8 years, don't know who he is. Now, that's just the guy. I got his name. I didn't print it, but that's what I was told by the school. So what do? I take that fact, and I put it online. I'm not saying anything's going on. I found these facts. Here's what they are. Make of them what you will. And then you go down that lane, and, of course, that leads you to look at the school, and you find out that, you know, there's been some ish business behind the office stuff. I'm not suggesting anything as regards children or care of children. And it's like, well, gee, this looks like maybe something wasn't maybe done as fully or in the way maybe I might do it. And so I note that, and then I follow through, and I find out that certain people who are very influential in politics and in some cases receive millions of dollars from the government also have a link to this school. So I'm not drawing any conclusions. I'm simply left with questions that says, okay, what does it mean, if anything, that this individual who's been throwing these allegations now, according to my reliable source, has an employer on his thing that he hasn't been at, according to some people. It doesn't mean he hasn't worked for him. It doesn't even mean he's been paid by them. You know, what does that mean contrasted with this school's whatever issues it has or doesn't have? And given the fact that some people who have particular, who may be interpreted to have some very particular political agendas, who also have a lot of money, what, and they're connected to this school that apparently, according to some public records, employs, you know, Jesse Griffin, but yet he's not there. Okay, I'm sorry, I have a mystery. I'm not alleging that I've solved it. I'm alleging no wrongdoing, that no laws were broken, or that anybody did anything the least bit inappropriate. I did what the responsible thing is, which is you contact the individual who runs the school, you reach out to Jesse Griffin, and you say, I'm going to publish something that says, you know, no, I didn't go tell them the story. I wanted them to get back to me. I said, I'm going to publish a story dealing with your, you know, what I've identified as your current state of employment. Would you have, like, to discuss it or make a comment? And when they come back with no comment, I have nothing left to do but put out the facts without making accusations. And that's the bottom line right there.
Yeah, the connection with the political connections with the school, it's Puffin Montessori School, I guess it's here in town, right? In Aaron,
right, which is, yes.
Right, and when you called over there, the gentleman that you talked to, a couple different people, said they'd never heard of Jesse Griffin, and your source tells you that, in fact, he has worked there, and that's his employment of record, right?
That's all I'm saying is that, you know, if you know, I have a reliable source that does public on, this is all above board record searches, and he's 100% reliable and has never steered me wrong, and I don't ask him what I know he does nothing wrong. I mean, he said, look, I'm telling you that if I, you know, look for what is Jesse Griffin's current employer, and this was going back when this story started to break, I'm telling you it's Puffin Hills Montessori School.
Right.
And if anyone doubts that, tell them to contact me, and then I'll they can contact my lawyer because this is a fact. So
and the surprising thing, though, is nobody knows he works there. So we also don't, we're also unaware, and it's none of our business, I guess. He doesn't have to tell us how he makes his house payment. But we do know he doesn't work for the school district any longer. And so it would be interesting to know, I guess, because who, and it's not how he pays his bills, that's not the issue. It's who's behind his blogging and who's supporting his ability to blog.
Is.
Right?
If anybody is.
Right, exactly. I mean, I don't know. Maybe he could have had an uncle that died and left him $10 million, as far as we know. I mean, but the question is when these people blog, it's interesting that, you know, when somebody like me, I mean, I'm on the radio, it's kind of you can challenge me, you have the ability to call
open
in
forum.
I can be held accountable. When these people blog, especially in a secret blog that he had for a while, it's really difficult to try to ascertain any kind of facts on individuals and who they are and where they're coming from.
If I watch a report on NPR versus Fox versus ABC and I see certain things, I may or may not expect a certain narrative to that story because I know who's behind him. Now, if Jesse's on his own and doing his own blogging, then I can know that that's Jesse's voice, or that's what, if there's any agenda behind it, it's Jesse. If, on the other hand, and I'm not saying this is the case, he is somehow, and I don't know that he is, you know, he is in some way being economically or financially compensated for doing that blog, then it makes a very big difference who is providing that funding, because people hire you to express their point of view, not yours. I am not saying he's doing that. I'm saying this raises that question, and it could be perfectly answered innocently tomorrow, and I would have no complaints.
All right.